next problem in page number 34, fourth question. Find k so that x square plus 2x plus k is a factor of the polynomial 2x power 4 plus x cube minus 14x square plus 5x plus 6. Then find all the zeros of the two polynomials. Okay, first we have to find the value of k, and they have given this polynomial x square plus 2x plus 4 is a factor of this polynomial. Okay, so if we divide this polynomial by this polynomial, the remainder will be 0 because it is a factor of this polynomial. Okay, so first let's we divide for that. Let us assume the polynomial p of x is equal to 2x power 4 plus x cube minus 14x square plus 5x plus 6. Okay. So, let assume the g of x polynomial is equal to x square plus 2x plus k. Okay. So, now we are going to divide the polynomial p of x by g of x. The remainder will be 0 because g of x is a factor of p of x. Now, whatever remainder we have getting, we have to equate it to the 0. Okay. So, first let's we divide. First write the divisor polynomial x square plus 2x plus k. Okay. Now write the dividend polynomial 2x power 4 plus x cube minus 14x square plus 5x plus 6. Okay. Now take the first term in the divisor, that is 2x power 4 should be divided by first term in the divisor, that is x square. So it is x square. So 2 into x square. So the quotient here is 2x square, then multiply the quotient with the divisor. 2x square into x square becomes 2x power 4. Okay, then 2x square into 2x. So plus into plus plus, then 2 into 2 becomes 4, then x square into x becomes x cube. So it is plus 4x cube. Then plus 2x square into k becomes plus 2k x square. Okay, so you have to subtract these two terms, change the signs, it is minus and it is also minus. Now we are going to subtract 2x power 4 minus 2x power 4, it will be 0. Then x cube minus 4x cube becomes minus 3x cube. Okay, then see here, minus 14x square minus 2k x square. Okay, so taking x square as common from these two terms, the remaining will be minus 14 minus 2k. Okay, so here it is minus of 2k plus 14. I can write minus of 2k plus 14 into x square. Okay, so minus 2k minus 14, minus 2k minus 14. I am taking minus as common and writing the remaining terms within the bracket. Okay, so it is minus 2k minus 14 x square. Okay, now drop down the next term, which is plus 5x. Okay, now see the first term, it is minus 3x cube should be divided by the first term of the divisor, that is x square. So x square becomes 1, it will become x. Okay, so minus 3x is the quotient. Now we have to multiply the quotient with the divisor. Okay, so it is minus 3 into x into x square plus 2x plus k. Okay, so multiply, it will become minus 3x cube, then minus 3x into plus 2x becomes minus 6x square, then minus 3x into k becomes minus 3kx. So write the term minus 3x cube, then minus 6x square, then minus 3kx. Okay, subtracting these two terms, fourth change the signs, it is plus, and here it is plus, and here also it is plus. Okay, so minus 3x cube plus 3x cube, it will be cancelled. Then see here, minus of 2k, that is minus 2k minus 14 into x square, then plus 6x square. So taking x square as common from these two terms, the remaining will be minus 2k minus 14, then plus 6, right within the bracket. So see here, minus 2k minus 14 plus 6 gives minus 8. So it is minus 2k minus 8 into x square. If we take minus as common from these terms, we will be getting minus of 2k plus 8 into x square. Clear? Then solve this, plus 5x plus 3kx. So it is plus 5x plus 3kx. Taking x as common from these two terms, the remaining of 5 plus 3k. So you can write 3k plus 5 into x. Okay, then drop down the last term, it is plus 6. Okay, now this is the new dividend. Take the first term alone, that is minus of 2k plus 8 into x square. It should be divided by the first term in the divisor, that is x square. So x square getting cancelled. The remaining is minus of 2k plus 8. So this is the quotient part. Then we have to multiply the quotient part with the divisor, which is minus of 2k plus 8 into x square plus 2x plus k. Okay, so see here, minus into 2k, so minus 2k, minus into plus 8 becomes minus 8 into x square plus 2x plus k. So minus 2k into x square, minus 2k x square, then minus 2k into plus 2x becomes minus 4kx, then minus 2k into k becomes minus 2k square. Then take this term, minus 8 into x square becomes minus 8x square, then minus 8 into plus 2x becomes minus 16x, then minus 8 into k becomes minus 8k. Okay, now group the x square terms alone, it is minus 2k x square minus 8 x square, then take the x terms, minus 4k x minus 16 x, then take the constant term, it is minus 2k square minus 8k. Okay, so on simplifying this, taking x square as common from these two terms, the remaining will be minus of 2k plus 8 into x square. Okay, then solving the x terms, minus 4k x minus 16 kx, so taking minus x as common, that is writing like this, minus of 4k plus 16, 4k plus 16 into x. Okay, then write the constant term, minus 2k square minus 8k. So it can be written as minus of 2k square plus 8k. Clear? Now you have to subtract these two terms. So change the signs, it is plus, and it is also plus. Now see here, minus of 2k plus 8 x square then plus of 2k plus 8 into x square, it will be cancelled. Then see here, plus of 3k plus 5 into x plus 4k plus 16 into x. Okay, so taking x as common from these two terms, the remaining are 3k plus 5 plus 4k plus 16 into x. So it is 3k plus 4k becomes 7k, 5 plus 16 becomes 21. So it is 7k plus 21 into x. So here I am writing 7k plus 21 into x. Then see here, it is plus 6 plus of 2k square plus 8k. So writing in the standard form, you will be getting 2k square plus 8k plus 6. Okay. So here I am writing plus 2k square plus 8k plus 6. Okay. So see here, the remainder of the degree of this term is 1, it is x power 1. So the degree is 1. Here the divisor degree is 2. So I have to stop the division. Now this is the required remainder. Now we are going to equate this remainder term to the number 0, because they have given g of x is a factor of p of x. So when p of x is divided by g of x, definitely the remainder will be 0, but we have got the remainder in this form. So we are now going to equate this term to the number 0. Okay. So let me write the remainder we have got. It is 7k plus 21 into x plus 2k square plus 8k plus 6. Okay. So this is the remainder, that is R of x. Okay. So applying division algorithm for the polynomials, p of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus R of x. Okay. So write the p of x, it is 2x power 4 plus x cube minus 14x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to g of x polynomial, that is x square plus 2x plus k into q of x polynomial. The quotient we have got, it is 2x square minus 3x minus of 2k plus 8. Okay. Plus the remainder value, that is 7k plus 21 into x plus 2k square plus 8k plus 16. Okay. So this is the representation of the polynomial p of x. Okay. Now we are going to equate. Equating the x coefficient of R of x. Okay. So see here, the remainder we have got is this term. The remainder we have no, that is 0. Okay. So now we are going to equate the x coefficients of both the remainders. Okay. First, the x coefficient of the remainder we have got, that is 7k plus 21. Okay. Then the remainder we have no is 0. Okay. So 0 can be represented as 0 into x plus 0. Okay. I am going to compare both the x coefficient terms and the constant terms to the number 0. So I am representing the number 0 as 0 into x plus 0. So it is having a x term and a constant term. Okay. So now I am going to compare the x coefficients of both the remainders. Now here in the LHS it is 7k plus 21, then in the RHS it is 0. So 7k plus 21 is equal to 0, 7k is equal to minus 21, k is equal to minus 3. Okay. So this is the value of k. Put k is equal to minus 3 in the polynomial g of x. Okay. So the g of x becomes x square plus 2x minus 3. Okay. So this is the g of x we have got. Okay. So we have found out the value of the k. Now we are going to find the zeros of the polynomials p of x and g of x. First, let's we find for the zeros of the g of x polynomial. So let x square plus 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay, for finding the zeros of this polynomial. Okay, now we are going to find the factors for the number minus 3, so that we can split minus 3 as plus 3 minus 1. Okay, so 3 into minus 1 becomes minus 3. Okay, so 3 minus 1 becomes plus 2. So we are going to write plus 2x as minus x plus 3x. Okay, so taking x as common from these two terms, we will be getting x minus 1, then plus 3 as common from these two terms, we will be getting x minus 1. So first writing the common term x minus 1, then x plus 3 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 1, then x is equal to minus 3. Okay, so the zeros of the polynomial g of x or x is equal to 1 and minus 3. Okay, thus we have found the zeros of the polynomial g of x. Then let's we move for finding the zeros of the polynomial p of x. Okay, from this polynomial we will be getting two zeros of p of x. Okay, from this polynomial we will be getting another two zeros for the polynomial p of x. Already we have found the zeros of this polynomial, that is the zeros of g of x. Now we are going to find the zeros for the polynomial q of x. Okay, so let us consider 2x square minus 3x minus of 2k plus 8. Okay, so substitute the value of k is equal to minus 3 in this term, we will be getting 2x square minus 3x minus of 2 into minus 3 plus 8. Okay, so it is 2x square minus 3x, then 2 into minus 3 becomes minus 6. So minus into minus 6 becomes plus 6, then minus into plus 8 becomes minus 8. Okay, so on simplifying, 2x square minus 3x plus 6 minus 8 becomes minus 2. So this is the quadratic polynomial. So let's substitute 2x square minus 3x minus 2 is equal to 0 for finding the zeros of this polynomial. By splitting the middle term method, find the product of x square coefficient and the constant term, it is minus 4. Okay, so the number minus 4 can be splitted as 1 into minus 4. So 1 into minus 4 becomes minus 4. 2x square minus 3x can be splitted as plus x minus 4x. So plus x minus 4x gives minus 3x. Okay, now taking x as common from these two terms, you will be getting 2x plus 1. Okay, then here taking minus 2 as common, okay, we will be getting 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. So x minus 2 into 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. On separately equating it to 0, x is equal to 2, and then x is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, thus the zeros of the polynomial p of x are 2 comma minus 1 by 2 comma minus 3 and 1. Okay.